Right, guys.
So we're just about to grid up for Raceroom ranked GT4 at Suzuka. One of my favourite tracks and some of my favourite class of cars. So let's see how this goes. Let's get into the game. Here we go, then. On the grid. Do we have launch control? Don't know if we have launch control in these. We've qualified fourth. Fairly close to the cars in front, apart from first place was like 5 seconds clear. Because he is mentally fast. Let's try not to kill ourselves on that one turn one. Raceroom rolling starts. It's basically when the leader goes across the line, we get control of the cars, kind of. A little bit of a mix of cars, mainly Lotuses and, like me, BMWs. You know I'm a bit of a BMW whore, though. It's my main car in ACC at iRacing GT3 at the moment. So we're presented with a chance to drive another one. That's only 11 cars in, I think. 15 minute race. Let's get to see if we can catch up with Mr. Ben. Slidey on the opening lap. Someone joined in late. Or quit, one of the two. I haven't got that Audi. That's just one of the new ones they've added in. I'd say they've added more and more ranked races. So it's definitely a growing platform. The quality of the racing's been really good, but it's a cops job, so. Gear too low. Wait to get my power now. Oh, we got that Lotus right, watch out. Leader's already 4 seconds clear of me on first lap, so winning isn't going to be an option. Oh, nicely done, sir. I was a bit early on the brakes there. All that Lotus is rapid on the brakes, what did you see? We got a bit of a gap to the cars behind, so I need to try and keep with this lead pack, otherwise I'm going to end up doing what I normally do, being a race on my own, which we don't want. Much of a warm-up, so it's sort of coming straight into qualifiers. I thought that was a bit more pace I could find. Luckily I didn't have to learn the track really. Slightly different look to it compared to some other games. So layout's the same, isn't it? This is making moves. That wasn't very good. Too tight in. Getting caught by the car behind us right now. A-pin or something, these guys. this is really annoying because it doesn't actually line up with the screen. It's like, normally they're in the divide in the bezel between the monitors and the screen. This car is not. Kind of got all scruffy there, Mr. Ben. Isn't that a kids' TV show? Like a magic shop or something. Nice. Just trying to go into the back of him into turn one. Get some speed. Use the back end. Coming up. Somehow held that really well. Little Beamer, come on. Next idea is I'm going to go in one of the other cars because I like to be in a different car to everyone else. Just because I'm weird like that. If I see a car that's not driven much, that's the one I want to learn to drive. Attack soon, aren't we? Right, this has got to be. It's definitely holding us up. Not a lot, but it is holding us up. Come on, get on the power, and it's a bad corner again. Getting caught by the Audi behind us, Mr. Medeiros. That's how that's said. Medeiros. We need to find a way past Mr. Ben. So far, we haven't got one. Turn one, maybe? Get enough of a run? I can't get a run, but the Audi on me has got a run. Oh, going backwards, that's not good. Kind of not gone well at all, has it? Oh, racing, you deeper guide. Some really good combos. This BMW drives really nicely. It's playful, but you can hold it in the slides. Very impressed. I think this is my first drive of GT4. I might have driven the Lotus once, but only for like a couple of laps around Bathurst. That's like in a practice session, so. Yeah, I feel good. It's definitely easier to drive than the BMW on iRacing. Not that I've tried that for a while, when that first came out. I was like, this isn't too bad, and then soon realised it was like a wallowy piece of crap. So I don't think it's meant to be. I think they've done an update recently, and they dropped some McLaren into the GT4 lineup, so. I'm losing time. Why am I losing time? Come on then. run the engine. Get you anywhere shifting like that. Audi's coming through the field like a map as this. First and second have disappeared. First has disappeared from second. Second's disappeared from us. And then there's like our little pack. And then I guess sort of 13 seconds back is the rest of us. I say pack, we're not really in pack. Two groups of two. Not really getting away from each other. Not really closing from each other. That was better, Wilkins. If you can get a run down the back straight into 130R, that would be, it's always a bit brave, but if you can get it done early, it's not too bad. Christ, getting this corner right there, which you haven't done. No, still going to have to try and follow him through 130R and then get the inside line. You have a look here. Stay close enough. That's how brakes and stuff though. We're on him now. There we go, here we go. Come on, baby. Oh, I've over revved it again. No! There goes that chance, right. Keep the pressure on him. Definitely got a mistake in him somewhere. So I to be fair, so. I do have a habit of making mistakes in these races when I really don't need to. My last GT2 race that I did last week shows that. I've lost two places when I started, which is not. I'm probably pulling all sorts of weird faces right about now. Face gets a bit funny when I come. Sometimes I get to talk as well. I can talk while I'm doing laps, but since there's like other someone to race, it gets a bit more intense. All that tire squirrel. No, it's not turning into speed, unfortunately. Probably not a bad thing being a bit further back because I carry more speed through run because I don't know when he's going to brake, so it makes it difficult to follow him. I don't know if he's going to brake. Couldn't carry more speed. Just not practice enough or confident enough to throw it. Gear shift that time. What is in his car that makes it so fast? Just show a nose. It's great late. We'll have that position and gear by. We're going to defend it, so. Don't be too cocky, Wilkins. Sometimes even just the threat of an overtaking maneuver is enough. Better old bit of work to see if we're going to catch the cars in front here. This lap. But at least we got that position back. It's not over yet. It's still right there. Still right there. It's good. For something that doesn't really, I don't think it splits these servers, Raceroom, but it definitely gets a good quality of racing across the pack. Like, there's definitely a skill differential between, say, the top half and the bottom half, but when you look at the gaps between the cars in the top half and bottom half, like, they're having a race and we're having a race. You get fun all the way down the grid. Okay, there's a couple of guys that are clearly more rapid, but that happens in all series really, doesn't it? Slow. Don't miss this gear change or we will have us. Okay, do it a bit early, doesn't matter. And across the line. Nearly. Where is it? There it is. There we go. Whew. So yeah. Just a quick one really. Cheeky bit of Raceroom. Again, excellent, excellent combination of car and track. GT4s are great fun. Very similar to GT3, just a bit slower and a bit more fun to throw around. And Suzuka. Can't go wrong really, can you? So without further ado, I'm going to call this one the end of the video. So if you haven't already, please feel free to like, subscribe, all helps out. Try to build the channel up a little bit. So, and if you like my race content, then I stream on Twitch quite often. It's Twitch JW Sim Racing. So I'll put a link in the description, maybe flash something up on the screen in a second. But yeah, take care.